The ocean is the lifeblood of the planet. If the ocean dies, then we go along with it. My name's Mill McCleary. I'm the Executive Program Director of Reef Relief. Reef Relief's mission and goals is to improve and protect our coral reef ecosystem. And when we teach people about our coral reef ecosystem, it starts on land and it starts in our own actions. The sunscreen issue came about in the state of Hawaii, and there were studies and evidence being done that shows that two chemicals in particular, octinoxate and oxybenzone, are harmful to corals and how they reproduce, potentially harmful for fish. And there's been new evidence that those chemicals could be harmful to humans as well. So once Hawaii passed the ban, we took a look at it here in Key West. And the Key West City government, Reef Relief, got together and started working on a ordinance to ban those two chemicals from sunscreens here. It's easy to find these brands that are ocean friendly. A lot of the major brands are already producing them. And then you can find some of these smaller companies, so they're not hard to come by. Sunscreens are just one thing we can do to help improve the water quality around us. And there's a laundry list of things we need to do to help protect the ocean and protect ourselves. But this is just that first step. The easiest way to find more information about the sunscreen ordinance that we've passed is to visit reefrelief.org. Click on the sunscreen button right on the home page. And remember, protect your skin, protect our reefs.